See, for the understanding the representation of function of as a vector, let us try to dig deep into what, like a vector, just think of a vector as a tuple or a series of buckets. Let me explain how. For example, if I have two dimensional plane, this coordinate system, 2D coordinate system, this point, any point, 1, 2 or something, any point, it's like the pair of two. So in that sense, it is a two tuple. Now in this two buckets, here I have one, and on the other side, the y is having two. So just see, this two tuple means that there are two dimensions. And also, what does this mean? That if I am selecting, okay, just let me tell you. Also, if this x is equal to 2, then y is equal to, like x is equal to 2 has nothing to do with y or anything. So they both are mutually orthogonal. So just tell you, let me tell you. This and this. They both are mutually orthogonal. So just if you take just this or just this, they are going to be orthogonal. So in that sense, a point or a tuple can be written as just this tuple and this tuple. Okay, so this, let me take this, how to select, as a selector function. That if I select just this part, then this is one. And I select just this part, then this. Okay? If I see that what this dimension, let us try to understand what the dimension of a vector means. So the dimension of a vector means that how many ways I can look at it. For example, I can look this as this just x-axis, x coordinate, and this y coordinate. So I can look at it in two forms. So the dimension equal to 2. Or in other words, the dimension I can represent in forms of number of or the pair of orthogonal vectors or the pairs in which I can represent it. So I can represent it in always form of two orthogonal pairs, not never more than that. So like v1 and v2 I select, then I am able to represent it in two. If I take this two, even though the buckets will contain some different value, let's say 1, 5 or anything, still the important point, or 0, 5 or anything, still the point remains that there are two buckets. So the dimensions are equal to the number of buckets. So if there are three dimensions, there will be three buckets, and so on. Now, if I take the discrete function f of n, the number of buckets will be equal to, just tell me how many buckets will equal to. Discrete function will have a bucket at 0, a bucket at 1, a bucket at 2, a bucket at 3, and so on. So, it has infinite number of buckets. Or in other words, I can write this function, let me say it's something like this. This is bucket at 0 or f of 0. This is bucket at 1. So let me, this is bucket at 0 which contains the value f of 0. Okay. So this bucket contains f of 0. This bucket contains f of 1. This bucket contains f of 2. This bucket contains this much value. Okay? So in that sense, what I am trying to say, this is f of 2. Okay? So in that sense, there are infinite such buckets which contain different values, and each bucket, just see, are orthogonal to each other. So in that sense, there are infinite number of buckets, and so therefore infinite dimensional vector. So, and also just see, the dot product of this vector with this vector is non-zero, but otherwise it is orthogonal to every other vector. So in that sense, you can think of it as a vector. And just if you have to find the component of this is the concept of the dimensions. Now there is a concept of projection. Okay, so by now you know the concept of dimensions. Now the concept of projection means that if there is some vector, how much is the content of the vector in this bucket? So for example, if this is phi, this angle is 37 degree. Okay, so in some sense, this length, this bucket will contain value 4 and this bucket will contain value 3, because 5, just see what will be the length by this, 5 cos 37 degrees, and this will be 5 sin 37 degrees. So this point will be 3, this 4 comma 3. So this is how we try to find the values in the bucket. So the finding the values in bucket is this, this is what is called projection. And now in this function, if I take some function f of n, and what is the component in this bucket f of 0? So to find the value of component, we need some selector function. So if I want to find the nth bucket value, water value, if I want to select the nth bucket, then I need a delta of, what we say, or let me say kth bucket, then n minus k, or the fifth bucket, okay? Delta of n minus 5, when I multiply this with f of n, then what I will get is f of 5. And therefore, what we say, this delta function as selector, or the projector, it projects the value of function in different dimensions. Okay, so these values f of 0, f of 1 are nothing but projections in some sense. Are you trying to get an intuitive feel that why, what is the importance of this Dirac delta function?